The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
Gotta be the man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 3729288. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 3729288. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J.B.L. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you download and install it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
You're nothing but trouble, but trouble's what I like. Got a whole lot to figure it out, so why start tonight? Just take a picture of me. Just flip
It's a really exciting time to be a fan of Disney because times are changing. It's evident with the series finale of Austin and Ally this Sunday. Really emotional over this one. I didn't want to believe the series was coming up on its series finale and getting ready to end. So many people, including Wacko Bob on the Wacko Network over on Mixlr.com, were trying to tell me, convince me that Austin and Ally was getting ready to end, but it is evident now. And now that it's apparent the series is ending after me refusing to want to believe this, I'm more excited to see what the future has in store for more opportunities for more Disney Channel stars. One of them is Olivia Holt, because I've been a big fan and supporter of Olivia Holt forever, and I really think the time for Olivia Holt to have her star shine brighter than it ever has before is emphatically now. It is time to really get in on the conversation about stars like Peyton List and Olivia Holt and many more, who I will reference over the next couple of weeks on this show. Was really sad over the series finale of Jesse, even more so on Austin and Ally, although it may have only thrived because of the music and had success because of the music more so than the acting coming from Ross Lynch and Laura Morano. It is over just like Jesse, and many others will follow. And with many other series getting ready to end, possibly the next one will be Liv and Manny. This is the time now for Olivia Holt to really show us what she can do. She has showed us what she can do before in the past, but she has yet to reach her peak. And that's the most exciting thing about Olivia Holt, guys, is she has yet to reach her peak. In roles for Disney's Kicking It and I Didn't Do It, it definitely shows us what Olivia Holt can do. But, I mean, more roles will come her way. She can be a hostess like Sabrina Carpenter for the Disney Radio Holiday Special. Sabrina Carpenter did a great job as the hostess of that event. And I think Olivia Holt can be a great hostess, too, if ever given the chance to, because she's so friendly. And she just has this unbelievable way to connect with fans, this unbelievable way to connect with fans and have this chemistry with fans and everybody she's worked with. I've never seen someone so friendly like Olivia Holt. Now, for a while there, I was posting a lot of Olivia Holt interviews for the media, and one thing that really jumped at me about Olivia Holt was the fact that she was so friendly. And because she's so friendly and she's so there to do everything for Disney in every role she's been given, I think the opportunity really needs to be thrown the way of Olivia Holt to really show us what she can do. And that's what the most I'm excited for about Olivia Holt, and that's why I've gotten into her conversation on her Facebook fan page. I've liked that, I've smashed that like button, and I've smashed that tweet button on her Twitter following her in the way of conversation, and you too can do the same. It's all happening at Olivia Holt. She's making a lot of appearances in the way of musical performances, promoting things for Disney's I Didn't Do It, which is in their second or third season. And there's going to be a lot of more seasons for I Didn't Do It, because when you talk about shows like Girl Meets World and I Didn't Do It, these are shows that you can have for the long haul for Disney. When series like Austin and Ally and Liv and Manny are ending all the time, there are always these series to fall back on, which in 2010, 2011, we didn't really have for Disney. The only thing we had to fall back on off the success of Hannah Montana and Wizards was a show like Shake It Up or Dog with a Blog, which really wasn't really offering us much in the way of exciting. But exciting times are here now for Disney fans, especially with more opportunities to check out more Disney Channel shows, more Disney Channel stars, more ways to watch Disney than we had back 10 years ago. What a difference 10 years has made, guys, because 10 years ago we didn't have Olivia Holt, we didn't have Sabrina Carpenter, Roland Blanchard, Dove Cameron. The chances now for everybody to get in on the conversation and really, you know, enjoy Disney and what they're offering, apart from 10 years ago when we probably had three or four shows which were really carrying Disney as their torch carriers. But now, there's more opportunities, and we need to see something happen for people like Olivia Holt, who I am a really big fan of. Have I fallen in love with Olivia Holt? Maybe not right away. I didn't fall in love with Olivia Holt. It took time for me to really become a fan of Olivia Holt, just as it did for me to become a fan of Sabrina Carpenter, which, by the way, guys, I'm going to be talking more about in the coming weeks. It took time for me to become a fan of Sabrina Carpenter and to fall in love with Sabrina Carpenter. I am a fan of Olivia Holt, and that doesn't mean that I'm not going to fall in love with Olivia Holt because I'm a fan of Olivia Holt, because in time, I probably will have the same thing happen to me that happened for me with Sabrina Carpenter. I will fall in love with Olivia Holt. It's happening for me, and it will become more apparent in the coming weeks, because this is my second or third video blog on the success of Olivia Holt. And can you really blame me for supporting Olivia Holt the way that I have? Because there's been a lot of conversation about the same three or four Disney stars and Disney shows. It's all about Liv and Manny. It's all about Girl Meets World. And again, these Disney stars are suffering because they're being put on the back burner. And we don't need to see someone like Olivia Holt end up on the proverbial back burner. We really need to throw Olivia Holt in the faces of Disney fans and make more Disney fans aware of what's really going on here, because there are so many Disney stars getting opportunities, and there are so many Disney stars. If 50% of the Disney stars are getting opportunities, the other 50 to 75% are not getting as many opportunities, which is something that really irritates me, because the same opportunities going the way of people like Austin Alley with Ross Lynch and Laura Morano, or Liv and Maddie with Dove Cameron, can be given the same way if I didn't do it in the way of Olivia Hope, because she's just so amazing to watch. She's so funny, she's so full of energy, and she's, dare I say, very unpredictable. And that's where it's really exciting to watch Olivia Hope, because you don't know what she's going to do from one minute to the next. Sure, you don't know what a Dove Cameron's going to do, or a Roland Blanchard or Sabrina Carpenter, but more so Olivia Hope, because she really needs to stand out like a Dove Cameron is. And because Dove Cameron is one of the more overwhelming popular superstars from Disney, then Olivia Holt has to do something far more outrageous and something far more ridiculous to stand out. And that's what we get from I Didn't Do It, which is Disney's answer to So Random, in my opinion, really Disney's answer out of Saturday Night Live. You know, I said, you know, what's Disney's answer to Saturday Night Live? What's Disney's answer to So Random? I think I Didn't Do It is obviously their answer to a show like So Random, because of the similarities the show presents and the way the show reminds us of a show like So Random, which was the spinoff of Sunny with a Chance after Demi went into rehab. This is the show that does that because of the comedy sketches, the different themes, the way the characters are portrayed by the likes of Olivia Holt and Piper Curta. This is the show, really, that's in a position to take over. Girl Meets World is a series you can easily get 6 or 7 seasons out of because of how Boy Meets World went to over 7 back in the 90s. It is expected for Girl Meets World to last that long, get the kids up to the point where they grab